Good morning, 47. We have a lead on the Shadow Client. ICA White Hats have traced the anonymous data received by our clients to one Olivia Hall, brilliant young hacktivist and suspect in a dozen cases of cyber vandalism. Using onion routing with state-of-the-art encryption, Hall went to a lot of trouble to stay untraceable. She is good, but we are better. Her digital trail has led us to a remote farm in Colorado, where satellite footage has revealed what appears to be the training camp for a private militia, led by an already registered target, Sean Rose, Australian environmental terrorist and explosives expert wanted for a series of public bombings. Rose was spotted near the scene of Thomas Cross's kidnapping, which makes him our prime suspect for the Shadow Client. Spurred by Eric Soders, the ICA Board of Directors has asked us to infiltrate the farm and eliminate Sean Rose, along with three other prominent militia members. Ezra Berg, retired Mossad interrogator. Penelope Graves, former Interpol anti-terror analyst. And finally, Maya Parvati, former assassin and gunrunner for the Tamil Tigers. I'll be honest with you, 47. I consider Eric Soder's reasoning hasty and ill-advised. Now, we cannot go against the wishes of the board, but we can conduct our own investigation. Whether a direct threat to the ICA or not, we need to know the Shadow Client's true agenda. I will leave you to prepare. Welcome to Colorado, 47. The militia has taken up HQ at an old apricot farm and appear to be training for a series of coordinated strikes, ranging from cyber attacks to full-blown guerrilla warfare. The Shadow Client appears to unite specialists and radicals from all over the map, mercenaries and terrorists, hackers and spies joined by an unknown common cause. Satellite scans indicate that the command room is below ground inside an old tornado shelter. Only Rose appears to have access, however, so to get inside, you will need to get creative. This environment is hostile and highly alert, so tread carefully. Good luck, 47.
Talking about?
I was just at the security station watching the feeds. There's this creepy guy interrogating the hostage. He wears like a 3D printed mask.
Oh, yeah, that must
be. Ezra Berg, legendary Mossad operative who specializes in chemical interrogation techniques, is here at the compound to interrogate a prisoner. My notes indicate he's set up a makeshift drug lab in a garage, and it looks like he's spending a lot of his time in the basement. Could be an opportunity there, 47. That is Sean Rose, terrorist turned insurgent.
Sir, don't throw stuff around.
That is Ezra Berg, former Mossad interrogator. His services are in demand at the moment.
And we have a system breakdown.
I'll fix it.
How can I miss you if you...
You look like you've done something you shouldn't, am I right?
Hey, you didn't hear me, sir?
Thank you.
bad boy right away, mate.
That is Penelope Graves, acclaimed anti-terror analyst. Strange to see her as part of this crowd.
Ah, Penelope Graves. Her nemesis.
Welcome to HQ.
Sean Rose. You're a tough man to find.
Please.
Okay. Hey, what are you doing?
Ezra Berg has been eliminated. Good work, 47.
You should holster that cannon, mate.
Oh, shit!
Oh. It's funny, thinking about it. A weapon shows you.
Intriguing. According to Graves' ledger on Sean Rose, he is hypersensitive to the effects of drugs, in particular, hallucinogens. Last time he tried, it triggered a nasty psychotic episode, channeling his fear of germs. Interestingly, the ledger also contains a record of his most recent OCD attacks. Desk, grandfather clock, and faucet. Rose appears to smoke cigarettes when he gets agitated. What if...
Like a professional. Put that thing away.
Hey, check up on the nitroglycerin. We need to make sure we got more than
enough. Oh, we got plenty.
Good. That reminds me, I need to check with Rose if we need anything.
Very clever, 47. This ought to rattle his cage.
Thank you.
should holster that gun.
Was confirmed down. Nicely done, 47. The battering ram has injured one of the strike team, point man by the name of Burgess, and according to those militiamen, Maya Parvati oversees training. Sounds promising. I suggest you infiltrate the strike team, 47. Perhaps you can relieve the hapless point man of his duties.
I don't know, I guess old Burgess had his head up his ass.
9 out of 10 accidents happen in the home.
They do say that. Anyway, the guy was lucky. Sprained his ankle, that's all. He'll be back in a couple.
So does Rose still supervise the training? Sure. Wow.
That's what I'm saying. We're watching the broadcast.
Just cross your fingers that the damn thing doesn't fail again. Rose gets a load of important photos.
Yeah. still...
That bad boy right away, mate.
That is Maya Parvati, Sri Lankan assassin turned pirate turned insurgent.
All right, let's go again. On your marks, ready, set, execute.
I'm back.
Well, well, our very own punching bag. Any broken bones?
Wounded pride, that's all.
Good to hear. All right, head over to the briefing area. We'll resume in a moment.
All right. Finally ready to show. Kind of a shame that Rose won't be here to see. But the show must go on.
Let's get to it. Burgess is back. We're finally ready to make this happen.
I expect you all to know this by heart. But in case amnesia has set in, here's the sequence. Advance to the car with haste. Eliminate the passengers. Retrieve the briefcase. Extract. Got that? And remember, speed and accuracy is the name of the game.
All right. Now go pick up your weapons and get in position. Move out!
Improve.
Team's performance was passable but lacked coordination. The point is to build up muscle memory. A perfect sequence of synchronized motion. We've been through this before.
All due respect,
nicely
boss.
Done, 47. Parvati won't know what hit her.
I don't know.
Parvati is down. Good work.
Are you okay?
I would give it up right away if I
put that way. You should holster that gun.
Enough! Stop!
So
yeah,
this
you whip. Go
test
hide.
That Rose has planned seems kind of cruel, doesn't it? I mean, I'm no softy or anything, but it feels excessive to me.
She's got it coming. And nobody could switch sides like Graves and just expect to be accepted. Tests are in order, man.
Yeah, sure, I get that. But playing on her past with Interpol like that? I don't know, man.
Penelope Graves is still new to this outfit, and it looks like Rose is going to test her dedication to the cause. He's arranged for one of the communications technicians to act as an outside agent. The tech is supposed to show her an Interpol badge and escort her to the slurry pit, asking her to betray the militia. Might I suggest a last-minute recasting, 47?
I just hope the technician knows how to act.
She used to be the enemy. I don't have any sympathy for that. I'm sure he'll be fine. He's got the badge, right?
Yeah, he showed it to me over by the tent.
Yes.
Over there. Go and deal with it and don't let it happen again.
Penelope Graves, we need to talk.
You're... what is this?
I'll explain everything at the slurry pit. It will be in your best interest to do as I say.
I understand. I'll see you there.
Huh?
Did you or any of your men lose a weapon over there? Better go pick it up.
I need a man here to check out these
services. Yeah,
I've spent all the significant moments in my life.
Graves, you are being recruited back into Interpol as an insider.
What? Who are you anyway? How did you find me?
That is not important. Think about this carefully. You could provide us with valuable intel. If you cooperate, the agency will overlook your unfortunate transgression.
And what if I refuse, huh? If I scream and get the guards here?
I wouldn't do that if I were you. Might prove unhealthy. I'll give you a few moments to think about it.
Good work, 47. This should give her something to think about.
Think, Graves. How did they get to you? Flight out of Lyon under assumed name. Passport provided through Delgado and that Vanisher guy. It looked clean. Changed clothes at JFK and again at Denver International. Charred the passport after leaving the hotel. Burner phone was dropped before I left the flight. It can't possibly be that. Diplomatic car out of Denver. Nothing unusual about the bus ride. Met up with Hall in the middle of nowhere. Burned everything. I saw her do it. There's no way. Hackers erased everything here day one. No money, no paper trails, no digital signatures. It's just not possible. It's not possible. I decline your offer. You know why? Two reasons. One, I am not a rat. I've peeked behind the curtain and I don't like what I'm seeing there, so I'm here to change things. And two, I don't buy it. There's no way Interpol would have found me. Hall erased my digital fingerprint. There is nothing connecting me to this place. So what gives? What are you up to?
Well done, Miss Graves. You passed the test.
Test? This was a test? Who set you up to this? Rose?
Yes, miss.
I can't believe it. Actually, you know what? That does sound just like him. What a waste of time.
That's all targets taken care of, 47. Now gain access to the tornado shelter.
Who are you?
What the?
Halt!
Let us do the weapon carrying here, sir.
47. It appears the door to the tornado shelter is protected by a biometric lock. To gain access, you need Sean Rose's body, or something equally convincing.
We trust in you, Private.
Why are you all up in my face, mister?
Please, behave.
So last night was interesting.
Oh, right. You were doing that bomb trigger for Rose. How's it work exactly?
Yeah, so Rose is building an explosive battery unit for a Link 4 smartwatch.
Oh, right, for the next target. It's this Devereaux guy?
Right. But Rose wants to control the time of detonation, so I designed this software trigger. Works by email. Devereaux checks it, the virus infects the watch, triggers the charge, and boom.
Well, that is hardcore. Man. These people don't piss about.
Yeah, well, still beats working at a bank. Doing this, don't we have security to deal with situations like this?
Plot thickens.
Someone left in a hurry.
Sean Rose was not the Shadow Client. That much is clear. Whoever commands the militia, they got out just in time. Look around, 47. We're getting closer.
Someone's done their homework.
Look how far it dates back. Hayamoto, Beldingford, Delvade. The Shadow Client has been tracking you for decades.
Now how is that possible?
It isn't. Every one of those missions were branded as unsolved or accidents. He must have been looking for a pattern, a certain M.O., which would mean...
He knows me.
Well, at least this shortens the list.
Some kind of network. Power players. From all sectors.
Familiar faces, too. Thomas Cross. Klaus Strandberg. Ether. And that's missing banker Eugene Cobb. Well, well.
There's a name. Providence.
What? No. No, it can't be.
The Hidden Hand. Thought they were a myth.
A hypothesis, nothing more. The idea that a small cabal of kingmakers, controlling enough corporate and political leaders, could effectively run the world in secret.
Maybe not so hypothetical.
Keep looking, 47. We need full disclosure.
Found something.
Sodas. But that would mean Providence has infiltrated ICA. And Eric Sodas is their operative. Bastard! It all fits. He was the one who persuaded the rest of the ICA board to greenlight this operation. This changes everything. Get out, 47. We got what we came for.
What about the Shadow Client?
He is no longer our primary concern. ICA has been compromised. I always wondered if Providence was real, but I never actually... I will need to confer with the board, but mark my words, 47. This will have consequences.
Rose is gone.
It was me, wasn't it? They tracked me. I don't believe it. I took every precaution.
Rose knew the risks. They all do. You did well, Olivia. I am proud of you. Now listen. The ICA knows about you. They kept you alive because they needed you, and now they don't. We won't talk again. Not until the storm is over.
I don't like it. This man nobody's capable of. You need to end this now.
I ran away as a boy. My friend and I. Away from that place. We came upon a small farming community. The people were dirt poor, but this woman, she took us in. We were awakened the next morning by the shots. A dozen people lay face down in the snow. A warden didn't like to leave witnesses. They shot the woman and her family last. They made sure that we watched the whole thing. This is your gift, the warden told us. Your gift and your curse. Touching lives. Only by ending them.
You know him.
Better than anyone.